The pace of change in the world today is so fast that every product, every process, and every person is either forging or failing the future. The only way to ensure that we as individuals and our organizations thrive is to wrestle breakthroughs from the jaws of a volatile, uncertain, complex, ambiguous, networked, and stressed world. I spent 25 years cracking the code of breakthrough. I support breakthrough leaders, be responsive, resilient, and utterly brilliant. Breakthrough teams, be connected, creative and collaborative. And breakthrough businesses, be agile, adaptable and able to land disruptive innovation.
If you ask most organizations if they want breakthrough or disruptive innovation, most of them will say, hell yeah, and they're right to. Breakthrough innovation brings with it incredible benefits for everyone in the world and the bottom line. But if it was easy, everyone would be doing breakthroughs left, right, and center, and they're not. That's because breakthrough is really, really challenging.
There's an evolutionary law, this is a cybernetics law, called the law of requisite variety. It says you either fit the world as the world changes, or you fail. If you're running a business that was designed in the 80s or the 50s, you're not going to thrive in the way that you could. All the areas in your life and your enterprise where you're stuck, if you take it apart and let some of it go and take some new pieces, you can build any breakthrough in the place of a breakdown, a fail, a challenge, a frustration.
The most powerful form of leadership on the planet is breakthrough leadership. The ability to lead teams and organizations so they have big, bold breakthrough ideas that make a huge impact in the world. And then crucially, how to sustain and implement those ideas against the resistance of the status quo.
Power in the present does not always lead to breakthrough innovation in the future. All right? And of course, we're standing in a company that has massive power in the present.